Is she?
Oh, yes, busy beavering away.
What's she doing this week?
Well, she's never built a snowman, so she's making a machine to make snow.
Oh, I've never made a snowman before. I can't wait to see if it works.
It works? Once again to Dear Mr. Barker, the fascinating fact program that answers your questions. Oh, that's right. Yes, Miss Chicken says we've got wolves and teddy bears in today's program and a whole host of other topics. So keep your brain cells bubbling and let's have the first question.
Hello, Mr. Barker.
My name is Ben.
My name is Jennifer. And what we want to know is how do you make fake blood?
Unfortunately, Mr. Barker can't be here, children. But I am Count Dogular. And that is a very good question, children. My good friend Frankenpaw will give you a blood-chilling answer.
Mr. Barker, why are you talking in that ridiculous accent?
I am Count Dogular, and I want to know about blood.
Give over. You're a big softy. You'd run a mile at the sight of blood. Mr. Barker, it's all right. It's just tomato ketchup. But contrary to popular belief, this isn't what they actually use for fake blood. Welcome along to Can't Cook, Just Can't Cook. Today we are creating a real speciality, blood. Some might call it cordon blood. This is what you need. A liberal sprinkling of custard powder, mixed together with a little bit of water. A little bit of flouncing here. Then, a generous dollop of syrup. That's enough. A little bit of red food colouring, and a little bit of yellow food colouring, and heat gently for a few moments. This is so the blood does not go lumpy. I hate lumpy blood. Oh dear, never mind. Here is one I made earlier. Look at this. Lovely blood. Ah, Liverpool. The cathedral, the Liver building, the ferry across the Mersey. And yes, the award-winning Merseyside Red Cross First Aid Team. Now, they meet up regularly to create accident scenes to help them with their training, and they're going to show me how to use my fake blood. Now, if you're a little bit squeamish, I suggest you watch the next minute of this film like this, because we're going to pretend there's been an accident, but it is only pretending. I'm just acting. Tom did all this for me. Now, Tom, what I'd really like next is a cut on my arm. Now, apparently you used dough, is that right? Yes,
this is what we made from wholemeal flour.
It's got the freckles and everything. I
can't believe
that.
Got everything to match your skin.
Very realistic, isn't it? Look at that. Yeah.
A little cut. Bit of blood, thick blood, what we made earlier. And there we go.
Bit of runny blood. Oh, a bit more acting. I think I'm ready. Oh! Now, over here, Lucia is giving Barbara some grazed hands, like when you come off your bike, and a cut on the leg. And she's also given herself a head wound. Nasty.
Paul, I need to do your ankle.
Ankle. Thanks, Andy. Well, we've had sprains, fractures, broken arms, grazes, eye injuries, head injuries, leg injuries, and all from custard powder, syrup and food colouring. Well, I hope that answers your question. Right, anyone for a game of football? Yay!
And now it's time for... Yes, it's time to ferret out a fact about the tallest, the strongest,
the smallest,
and the longest things, people, and places in the whole wide world. And this week, it's the largest fish and chip shop in the world. It's in West Yorkshire at Guiseley, and it's called Harry Ramsden's. And in one day, they can serve half a ton of fish and nearly a ton of chips. Yum, yum. Oh, they're back. Now then, we've had some letters here from Dominic Hewitt, who's 9, Juliet Kerr from Kent, and Eleanor Priestman from Yorkshire. And they all want to know how teddy bears are made. So, if you and your bears are sitting comfortably, we'll begin our bear-y tale. It's like fairy tale. Oh, please yourselves.
Look for the bear necessities.
In the beginning, the bear has to be designed. Jacqueline thinks about how big and cuddly she wants the bear to be and what sort of material she wants to use. This is her design for Shropshire Bear. A paper pattern is made for each of the pieces that will make up the bear. And metal cutters, the same shape as the pattern, are placed on the furry fabric, and a heavy press is used to cut the pieces out. Then all the pieces are kept in a big drawer with the bear's name on until it's ready to be sewn together, inside out. And once he's got his eyes in place, the pieces are turned the right way out. And then they're ready for stuffing. Shropshire Bear is stuffed using this machine. The nose part is hand-stuffed with wood shavings to make it firm. I bet that tickles. Ooh, he looks much more like a teddy now, doesn't he? All he needs now are some washers and long clips which fix his arms, legs and head onto his body. And he's ready for the finishing touches. Neat stitches in his back, a nifty nose, a smiley face, and then he's smartened up with a good brush and a silky ribbon.
Just the bare necessities.
And ready, Teddy, go!